I rise today to oppose House Bill 1437 and the proposed 2013-14 budget. My Democratic colleagues and I talked until we were blue in the face, and then we talked some more. But I am standing one more time to voice my opposition to this inadequate budget. When the citizens of the 185th Legislative District elected me to represent them, they did so with the expectation that I would do everything within my power to promote legislation that was in their best interest. Sadly, this budget simply isn't. For many of us in this House, we can remember a time when education was a priority, when it was more than just a talking point. And many of us are products of the investments that were made into our futures. No matter how many times I have to sit in this chamber and watch, as a majority votes to underfund our schools, I will never buy into the idea that this is somehow better for our Commonwealth. 20,000 public school employees have lost their jobs. And for those that are keeping their jobs, things are becoming ever more difficult due to the lack of funding. You want to know what this budget does do for education? It guarantees larger class sizes, lower test scores, the elimination of important programs like tutoring, art, and music, and as a result, citizens of this Commonwealth will be forced to pay higher property taxes. For my constituents, property taxes are already through the roof. We are dumping a greater tax burden on citizens while continuing to cut taxes for large corporations, just like we have in the previous two budgets. This budget also fails to create jobs, something the supporters of this bill speak a lot about. Why aren't we addressing this issue head-on in this budget? Pennsylvania was once a national example for job creation. Now we are an afterthought at best and a laughingstock at worst. When will these corporate tax cuts begin to pay dividends in the job market? It seems that we keep passing the same budgets, waiting for these same decisions to somehow yield different results. Where is the severance tax on shale drilling? Why aren't we closing the Delaware loophole? Why are we more determined to see our children suffer than we are to bring in new reliable tax revenues? I am not the first person to ask these questions, but for some reason, the answer is tough to come by. I stood up here a few weeks ago and said that we can do it better. And I meant it then, and I mean it now. We can do better than this. Unfortunately, my Democratic colleagues and I were shut out of negotiations. So what is before us is what it is. But I will not be voting in favor of this budget. I will be giving a no vote, and I encourage you to do the same. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.